Namaste. Welcome to the lecture series on the subject Applied Thermodynamics. This is Module 2, Gas Power Cycles, Lecture Number 6. Myself, Dr. Yan Satish Kumar, Associate Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Kendra Engineering College. So in this lecture, I will continue to solve numericals on gas turbine cycles, and also I will give you numericals for you to solve. So let us solve this problem. A gas turbine cycle having two-stage compression with intercooling between stages and two-stage expansion with reheating in between the stages has overall pressure ratio of 8. The maximum cycle temperature is 1400 Kelvin and the compressor inlet conditions are 1 bar and 27 degrees Celsius. The efficiencies of the compressors and turbines are 80% and 85%. The efficiency of the compressors are 80%, turbines are the 85%. Assuming that the air is cooled back to its original temperature after first stage compression, the gas is reheated back to its original temperature after the first stage of expansion, determine the net work output and the cycle efficiency. So this is a two-stage compression and two-stage expansion. So with the pressure ratio of 8, overall pressure ratio of 8. So maximum cycle temperature, that is at the end of the heat addition, right, 1, 2, 3, 4, that is T5 in this case, and this is P1, this is T1, and both the compressors have the efficiency of 80% and both the turbines have the efficiency of 85%. So perfect intercooling is given. You see, assuming that the air is cooled back to its original temperature after the first stage compression, means perfect intercooling. And gas is reheated back to its original temperature. So perfect reheat also. Okay. Now this is the TS diagram for this cycle, gas turbine cycle. So one is the entry point to the compressor. So P1 is 1 bar and T1 is 300 Kelvin. Maximum temperature of the cycle is 5, you see here. So that is 1400 Kelvin. So 1 to 2S is isentropic compression, 1 to 2 is the actual compression. So T1 is equal to T3 because of the perfect intercooling. 3 to 4S is isentropic compression, 3 to 4S is the actual compression. 5 to 6S is isentropic expansion, 5 to 6S is actual expansion in the first turbine. 7 to 8S is the isentropic expansion in the second turbine. 7 to 8 is the actual expansion in the second stage turbine. So this is very, very important here. Now overall pressure ratio, actually that is P4 by P1. So P4 by P1, so that is given as 8. Since pressure ratios are equal, so P2 by P1 is equal to P4 by P3 is equal to P6 is equal to P7 by P8. So this, when pressure ratios are equal, so it will be equal to the square root of the overall pressure ratio. Overall pressure ratio is P4 by P1 or P5 by P8. So square root of this, that is square root of 8. So now square root of 8 you have to find out. Since P1 is given here, so P2 is equal to P3 is equal to P4 is equal to P7 is equal to, you have to find out using this ratio. Since P1 is equal to P3, so both are 1 bar, right? So P2 is equal to P3, so that is 1 into root 8. So root 8 is 2.83 bar. So P2 is equal to P3, that is 8 and P8. Sorry, not 8, it is 7. P2 is equal to P3 means this pressure here. Okay, so on same line you have 6 and 7, so P6 is equal to P7, so that is also 2.83 bar. So this is how you have to find out the intermediate pressures. I repeat, is it all pressure stages are equal, so P2 by P1, that's first stage pressure ratio in the compressor, is equal to the second stage pressure ratio P4 by P3, is also equal to the first stage expansion pressure ratio in the turbine, second stage pressure ratio of expansion in the turbine. So when equal pressure ratios are given, I already see, I'll prove that P2 by P1 into P4 by P3. I'll multiply the two stage pressure ratios. They are equal. Okay, I'll multiply. So this is equal to, now P2 is equal to P3, you see constant pressure line here, you can see. So this gets cancelled. So it becomes P4 by P1. Okay. So now pressure ratios are equal. So this can be written as P2 by P1 whole square. So P4 by P1 is equal to P2 by P1 whole square, or P2 by P1, that is pressure ratio of the first stage, is equal to square root of P4 by P1, that is overall pressure ratio. So that is what is obtained. You see, square root of P4 by P1 is equal to P2 by P1. So this is just I am showing a proof. Okay. Now let us begin the calculations. So process 1 to 2 is isentropic. So as all of you know, T2S is equal to T1 into P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So after proper substitution, so you can see a pressure ratio is 2.83. Overall is 8. Okay. So you'll get T2S is 403.95. Now make use of isentropic efficiency of the compressor stage 1. It is given as 0.8. So we'll find out T2, the actual temperature at the end of the first stage compression is 429.89 degree Kelvin. Now T3 is equal to T1 by perfect intercooling, and P4 by P3 is equal to P2 by P1 equal stage pressure ratio. So T4S becomes equal to T2S. So no need to calculate that. So when T3 is equal to T1 and pressure ratio is also equal, so at the end of the second stage compression, that is T4S, will be the same temperature as that of the T2S. Since eta C1 is equal to eta C2, so T4 also becomes equal to T2. So this temperature is also equal, 2 and 4 also equal. Or else you can check that using the formula. T4S by T3 is equal to P4 by P3 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, and use the efficiency of the second stage compressor eta C2. Since they are equal, you'll get the same answer. Now there are two compressions, 1 to 2 and 3 to 4. So compressor work WC is equal to WC1 plus WC2, that is Cp into T2 minus T1 plus Cp into T4 minus T3. So 2 Cp into T2 minus T1, so 2 into 1.005 into 429.9. minus 300, so it is 261.19 kilojoules per kg. Now let us go to the expansion part. So 5 to 6S, right? 5 to 6S. So T6S by T5 is equal to P6 by P5 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. From this, you can calculate what is T6S, which comes around 1039.72 degree Kelvin. Now use the turbine efficiency formula for the first stage, right, and find out the T6. So the procedure remains same. First use the isentropic process, find out the temperature at the end of the isentropic compression or expansion, then use the compressor efficiency or turbine efficiency and find out the actual temperature at the end of compression or expansion. So actual temperature at the end of expansion of the first stage, T6 is 1093.76 Kelvin. Now here, since it is perfect reheating, so T7 becomes equal to T5, and also pressure ratio P5 by P6, that is first stage expansion, is equal to P7 by P8 second stage. So then automatically T8S should be equal to T6S. And since efficiency are also equal for both the stages of the turbine, so T6 should be equal to T8. So this temperature is also equal. Now, since expansion is carried out in two stages, so turbine work will have two parts, first stage turbine as well as second stage turbine. Cp into T5 minus T6 is the first stage expansion work, whereas Cp into T7 minus T8 is the second stage expansion work. Since T5 is equal to T7 and T6 is equal to T8, you can write as 2 Cp into T5 minus T6. After substitution, the total turbine work output is 615.54 kilojoules per kg, and the net work output is Wt minus Wc, which comes around 354.35 kilojoules per kg. Now, to find out efficiency, so you have to find out heat supplied. So heat supplied from 4 to 5, that is actual the heat addition process, also from 6 to 7 during reheat. So very, very important. So while calculating heat input, especially when there are multi-stage expansion, so reheat also should be considered as the heat addition. So Cp into T5 minus T4, that is during the process 4 to 5, and during the reheat 6 to 7, the heat added is Cp into T7 minus T6. So Cp is taken common outside 1.005, and substitution is made for other temperatures, so T5, T4, T7 and T6, and you'll get heat supplied as 1282.72 kilojoules per kg, and after substituting in the efficiency formula, W net by Q in or QH, you'll get as 27.6%. Okay, now this problem you can solve yourself. Determine the efficiency of a gas turbine having two stages of compression with intercooling and two stages of expansion with the reheat. Given that pressure ratio is 4, okay, minimum temperature of the cycle is 27 degrees Celsius, maximum temperature of the cycle is 600 degrees Celsius. Efficiency of the turbine, compressor and regenerator are equal to 80%. Regenerator efficiency means nothing but effectiveness. So effectiveness of regeneration is 80%. So I hope you can solve this problem. Okay. Now let me solve this problem. A two-stage gas turbine cycle receives air at 100 kilopascal and 50 degrees Celsius. The lower stage has a pressure ratio of 3, while that for the upper stage is 4. For both the for the compressor as well as the turbine. So lower stage pressure ratio is 3, while for that of the upper stage is 4 for compressor as well as the turbine. The temperature rise of the air compressed in the lower stage is reduced by 80%. So effectiveness of intercooling is only 80%. Temperature is reduced by 80% means effectiveness of the intercooling in its intercooler is 80%. Also, regenerator of 78% effectiveness is used. The upper temperature limit for the cycle is 1100. That is the maximum temperature in the cycle is 1100 degrees Celsius. The turbine and compressor efficiencies are 86%. Calculate the mass flow rate required to produce 6000 kilowatt. Okay. So two-stage compression with a two-stage expansion. So 1 to 2 years is isentropic compression, 1 to 2 is the actual compression, 3 to 4 years is the second stage compression, 3 to 4 is the actual compression, 5 to 6 years is first stage expansion, 5 to 6 is the actual expansion, 7 to 8 years is the isentropic expansion in the second stage, 7 to 8 is the actual expansion in the second stage. So P1 is given as 1 bar and T1 as 288 Kelvin. Efficiency of the intercooling, that is during process 2 to 3. So T3 is not equal to T1 because from T2 it is cooled only up to 80%. So efficiency of the intercooling is 0.8. Epsilon or efficiency of regeneration is 0.78. Maximum temperature in the cycle, you see, you have to make out that point, which is maximum temperature. So you have to draw the TS diagram first for two-stage compression, two-stage expansion cycle. So T5 is 1373 Kelvin. And efficiency of compressor for stage 1 and stage 2, as well as efficiency of turbine for stage 1 and 2, all the 4 are equal to 0.86. So now you have to find out the mass flow rate of air for a power generation of 6000 kilowatt. So let us begin as usual. Process 1 to 2s is isentropic compression. So for isentropic compression, you know that T2s by T1 is equal to P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So you can find out T2S from this, which is 410.75 Kelvin. As usual, once you find out T2S, Next, you have to find out is T2. This is step by step you have to move. So for finding out T2, you have to use the isentropic efficiency of the compressor for stage 1. Suppose if you are given different efficiencies for stage 1 and 2, so different efficiencies you have to use. Okay. So here it is 0.86, right? So is equal to T2S minus T1 divided by T2 minus T1. So you will find out what is T2 from this. Now comes the, you have to find out T3. When perfect intercooling is given, you used to take it as T1 is equal to T3. Now that is not the case because intercooling efficiency is given, which is 80%. So actually air is cooled from 2 to 3. So actual cooling is T2 minus T3. Ideally, it would have cooled from to 1. This is instead of up to 3, it would have been cooled up to 1. T1 would have been equal to T3. So ideal cooling is T2 minus T1. Actual cooling is T2 minus T3. So from this, if you simplify by using the efficiency of the intercooling, so you can find out the temperature after intercooling as 316.54 Kelvin. Now coming to the second stage compression, so process 3 to 4S is isentropy compression. So you know the relationship, T4S by T3 is equal to P4 by P3 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. It is clearly mentioned in the problem that for the second stage compression, the pressure ratio is 4. So for the first stage, it was 3. For the second stage, it is 4. That means P2 by P1 is equal to 3, whereas P4 by P3 is equal to 4. So same as P5 by P6. This is also 4. So this ratio is 4, whereas this gap is 4. 3, sorry. P7 by P8, which is also equal to P2 by P1. So using this relationship, you can find out the temperature at the end of the second stage compression as 470.57 degree Kelvin. And now use the efficiency of the second stage compressor, which is also equal to the first stage, that is 0.86. So you can find out actual temperature at the end of the second stage compression, T4, as 495.64 Kelvin. Now coming to the expansion, let us come to the first stage expansion. So that is 5 to 6S. Right, so T6S by T5 is equal to P6 by P5 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So T6S is equal to T5 into this is 1 by 4 because P6 by P5 is 1 by 4 whereas P5 by P6 is 4. So as I told you earlier, so same pressure ratio P4 by P3 and P5 by P6 pressure ratio is same. You can see I mentioned here before itself. So using that, you can find out the temperature at the end of the isentropic expansion process 5 to 6, that is T 5 to 6 S, that is T6S, as 923.59 degree Kelvin. Now use the first stage turbine efficiency formula, eta T1 is equal to T5 minus T6 actual expansion divided by isentropic expansion T5 minus T6S, and after proper substitution and simplification, you will get the actual temperature at the end of the first stage expansion is 986.51 degree Kelvin. Now process 6 to 7 is reheating, you can see. So here you have to assume T7 is equal to T5 is equal to 1373 Kelvin. That means perfect reheating is assumed. So because without T7 you cannot proceed. So nothing is given about reheating efficiency, so you have to assume it as perfect reheating. So now 7 to 8S, you have to come to the second stage expansion here. Look at these points. So this is isentropic expansion. So T8S by T7 is equal to P8 by P7 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So T8S is equal to T7 into P8 by P7 is 1 by 3 because previous slide I shown you this pressure ratio is 3. P2 by P1 and P7 by P8. It is 3. Since it is P8 by P7, you try it as 1 by 3. And T8S, you will get as 1002.79 degree Kelvin. Now use the second stage turbine efficiency. You see, this is what step by step you have to proceed in the problems while solving gas turbine problems. So that's also 0.86, that is second stage turbine efficiency. And writing appropriate formula, that is actual work output is T7 minus T8, isentropic work output is T7 minus T8S. So always remember turbine numerator is less, denominator is more, even for the compressor, numerator quantity should be less, denominator quantity should be more, so that the efficiency is less than 1 always. This is how you can remember the formula. And after simplification, you will get T8 as 1054.53 degree Kelvin. Always you see T8 is less, T8 is more. Because you can see here, T8 is at higher level than T8 is. So that's what you have to compare from the, or you have to find out, you can cross verify the answers. Now here we are using regenerator. Okay. Regenerator is used to utilize the temperature of the exhaust gases. So gas is leaving at 8 here. So it will be a much higher temperature than T4. So you have to make use of the regeneration here. So after regeneration, so your temperature will be somewhere here. So this will be, can be taken as X. Okay. So efficiency of the regeneration is, actual heating is Tx minus T4 divided by ideal heating, which can be done from T8 to T4. You see, T8 is the turbine exhaust gas temperature here. T4 is the air leaving the second stage compression. So if the perfect reheating is there, then T4 should reach up to T8. That is ideal heating. So that should be in the denominator. So but actually it is heated up to Tx because of the effectiveness is less than 1, which is 0.78 in this case. So if you simplify, you will find out Tx as 931.65 degree Kelvin. Now once you finish off all the temperature calculations, let us go for the work and efficiency calculations. So compressor work, two stage compression, Cp into T2 minus T1 plus Cp into T4 minus T3. So after proper substitution, so I request once again all of you to cross verify my substitution and calculation. You will get the answer as 323.44 kilojoules per kg. And turbine is also, turbine work is also carried out in two stage expansion process. So Wt is equal to Cp into T5 minus T6 plus Cp into T7 minus T8. After proper substitution, you will get as 708.38 kilojoules per kg. So net work output is W, net is equal to Wt minus Wc. You will get as 384.95 kilojoules per kg. Now, you know that power is equal to mass flow rate of air into W net. So power is given as 6000 kilowatt. So 6000 into 1000. Okay, and WN is nothing but 384.95 kilowatt means into, sorry, kilojoules means it is into 1000. Okay, so if you simplify, you will get M dot as 15.59 kg per second. So this is how you have to find out the mass flow rate of the air. Okay, P is equal to M dot into WN. So P is given as 6000 kilowatt multiplied by 1000. W you calculated in kilojoules multiplied by 1000. Now heat supplied QH, so 4 to, not 4, X to 5. See, this is after regeneration, the point is X. So X to 5 is one heat addition process here, and then reheating from 6 to 7. So Cp into T5 minus Tx, Cp into T5 minus Tx is the heat addition process in the heat exchanger, whereas reheating is from Cp into, that is 6 to 7, that is Cp into T7 minus T6. So after substitution, you will get QH is equal to 831.98 kilojoules per kg. Efficiency is equal to W net by QH, so you will get it as 0.463 or 46.3%. So now I will give you three more problems for you to solve. One is this. In a gas turbine plant working on a Brayton cycle, the inlet conditions are 1 bar and 27 degrees Celsius. The compression of air is carried out in two stages with a pressure ratio of 2.5 for each stage. You see, be careful. Each stage pressure ratio is given, not overall. With intercooling to 27 degrees Celsius. So initial temperature is 27 degrees Celsius. Intercooling also, after intercooling also, temperature is 27 degrees Celsius. that means it is perfect intercooling. The expansion is carried out in one stage with a pressure ratio of 6.25, because 2.5 each stage, two stage compression, so 2.5 into 2.5, so it has to be 6.25. Even though it is not given, it should be taken as 6.25. The maximum temperature of the cycle is 800 degrees Celsius. Efficiency of the turbine at the compression stages are 80%. So you have to find out the compressor work, turbine work, heat supply, cycle efficiency, and the air flow rate. So easily you can do this. It's not a big issue. The pressure ratio of an open cycle constant pressure gas turbine is 6. Open cycle problem. Pressure ratio is 6. The temperature range of the plant is 15 degrees Celsius and 800 degrees Celsius. That means inlet to the compressor and inlet to the turbine. So T1 is 15 degrees Celsius, T3 is equal to 800 degrees Celsius. Calculate the efficiency of the plant and the power developed by the plant for an air circulation of 5 kg per second. So mass flow rate of air is given as 5 kg per second, and you have to find out air fuel ratio, MA by MF. So MF into CV is equal to MA into CP into temperature difference during heating, that you know. So I solved this in one of the previous problems. So using that you can find out MF here. Then specific fuel consumption, that is fuel consumption per kilowatt power, you have to find out. That also you can do. Neglect losses in the system, use the following data. For both air and gases, CP should be taken as 1.005 and gamma is equal to 1.4. So what is gas and air and gas here? You see, in the compressor, only air is compressed. But when it undergoes combustion, so it becomes a gas. Products of combustion are nothing but considered as gases. So its CP and gamma value will be usually different. But here it is assumed to be, same. That means for that gas also, you have to assume the CP value as 1.005 and gamma is equal to 1.4. And even it is same even for the turbine during expansion. Calorific value of the fuel is given as 42,000. Efficiency of the compressor and turbines are given. And combustion efficiency is given. So combustion efficiency. So only 95% of the fuel is efficiently converted into heat, or calorific value is efficiently converted into heat input. So your heat input should be multiplied by 0.95. So that's very, very important here. Okay. Now last problem, that also you can try. In a gas turbine unit with this two stage compression and two stage expansion, the gas temperature at the entry to both the turbines are same. So gas entry to both the turbines are same means perfect reheating. The compressors have an intercooler with effectiveness of 83%. So intercooler effectiveness is given. So we already solved one such problem. The working temperature limits are 25 degrees Celsius and 1000 degrees Celsius, while the pressure limits are 1.02 bar and 7 bar. So 25 degrees Celsius is the T1 and maximum temperature, this is two stage expansion and two stage compression, T1, 2, 3, 4, so it is T5, so T5 is 1000 degrees Celsius. And P1 is 1.02 bar and P4 is 7 bar. Assuming that the compression and expansion process in the compressors and turbine are adiabatic with the efficiency of 84% and turbine efficiency of 89%, for both the stages. So both the stages of the compressors have the efficiency of 84%, whereas both the stages of the turbine have the efficiency of 89%. So you are supposed to calculate air fuel ratio at the combustion chambers if the calorific value is 38,500 kilojoules per kg. Also you have to find out the power output in kilowatt for an air flow rate of 1 kg per second and the overall cycle efficiency. So I hope you can try to solve this problem. You may not find it any difficulty to solve these problems. Okay. So with this, I conclude this lecture number 6, right? And I will come up with the remaining theory part of introduction to jet propulsion in lecture number 7 and 8. Thank you.